soft temperature. I'm going to move this around a little bit. You can see the picture has a little bit of a blue tinge to it, which is fine with me. It was kind of a blue morning. The sky was a little bit cloudy, giving off a blue feel to it. So I'm going to leave it right where it is. Next thing I'm going to do is come down to my blacks, bump them down a little bit to give us some contrast. Bump my clarity slider a little bit, and that just gives us a little bit of sharpening. You really don't want to bump your clarity slider up too much. As you can see, it kind of makes it look bad. But I just do that for a little bit of sharpness. Vibrance, I think we're okay. I'm going to bump down the yellow saturation just a little bit. And the yellow luminance. So when you go into Photomatics, which is the next step, it tends to make all this stuff that's kind of yellowish green, almost like a toxic looking green, and it looks really bad. So a way to get rid of that is to bump down your saturation and luminance in your yellow slider. What else do we have here? I'm going to bump up the sharpening a little bit. I sharpen in RAW, and then I sharpen once again in Photoshop, so it's good to do both. And then we can check enable profile corrections. In this case, I don't like it. Sometimes it makes the picture look better. In this case, it does not. Remove chromatic aberration. I always do that. The next step is going to be hold down Command. I'm on a Mac machine, so if you have Windows, go ahead and figure out those equivalent shortcuts. And I'm going to select all four of my shots, my bracketed photos, and hit Sync. You want all these to be checked, so you can hit Check All and Synchronize. Now, once those are synchronized, I'm going to go up here to my Export, or I guess right-click, go up to Export, and I'll show you how to set up my export. I export to a certain folder on my desktop. File naming, whatever you want it to be. I go with color space, sRGB, quality 100, no watermark, and export. After those files export, you can go ahead and close down Lightroom for now and open Adobe Bridge. Next thing I do is select all of my pictures. If you don't have Adobe Bridge, you can just open out of your Finder, your file folder, and do the same thing. I'm going to select all four of the pictures, and I'm just going to drag them into Photomatics, and hit OK, and hit OK again. I do not align source images, remove ghost, or reduce noise. Sometimes I'll use reduce noise if the shot is too noisy upon the first process. In this case, I don't think it'll be. And wait for this to load up. So let's go ahead and close this presets panel and hit fit. That'll fit the picture to the screen. And now I'm going to hit default to reset the Photomatics tool board. Make sure you have your histogram up over here so you can check your exposure of your shot. In this case, it is not bright outside, so you want a little bit underexposed shot, but you don't want to lose any of the blacks or the whites. So the first step I take, I use these steps every time I process an HDR picture. Excuse me. Strength, 100. Then I'm going to go down to the blacks, put it up a little bit, and the whites, put it up a little bit. So basically, I'm going to try to get the ground to look good, and maybe the sky. See my sensor's dirty here. And then I will blend the water in Photoshop. So I'm going to bring the black down a little bit, maybe. Lighting adjustments. Kind of like to move these back and forth. sharpening, I do like to use this. I'm going to go with mild sharpening. It's going to pull a lot of the detail back in. We can go with strong and see what it looks like. Sometimes strong destroys the picture. In this case, it looks good because you have all these rocks and you want them to be nice and sharp. So hit done with that. And now you can save it, or I just hit close and then you can have the chance to save it. And I'm going to save it at the same folder that I saved my other 3 JPEGs. Make sure to save it as file JPEG format and go ahead and hit save. And once it saves, it will close down. So the next step is to open Adobe Bridge. If you don't have Adobe Bridge, go ahead and learn how to load the files in on layers over top of each other in Photoshop. You can Google that, it's pretty easy to learn. If you do have Bridge, go ahead and select all 5 files, go to Tools, Photoshop, Load Files into Photoshop Layers. Now this is just going to take our files and load them in one on top of the other in Photoshop. Now I have everything loaded up in Photoshop as layers. Kind of see that, go over here to your eyeballs and click down. You can see the different layers of exposures. You want your Photomatix exposure on top. And then let's go with the darkest layer to the lightest layer under it. I'm running CS6. If you do not have CS6, your controls might look a little bit different. Here are the basic controls that I like to have. You can go with whatever suits you, but this is what works for me. I like to go with my histogram, actions panel, then I have my luminosity mask, which you're not going to use in this tutorial. What else do I have in here? And my adjustments, so just basic stuff. So the first thing we're going to do is make a new layer mask. So what we're going to do is we're going to put a mask on top of this picture. So let's go up to layer, layer mask, and reveal all. Now you see it's going to put this white piece of, it's kind of like a piece of paper that's just covering up or revealing this picture. So always remember that a white layer mask will reveal the picture, a black layer mask will conceal it. So if I put a black layer mask over this, you'd see the picture under it because it's hiding this current picture. I like to set up shortcuts to make layer masks. So for me, when I make a layer mask, I just hit the layer I want to make the mask on and then Command M. And you can set that up on your Photoshop as well. So let's, first thing we're going to do is, we're going to hide this layer, and we're going to look at the layer under it. So looking at the layer under this layer, the only thing I see that I might want to blend into the current layer is part of the sky. And I don't even know if I want that. Let's give it a try. So go ahead and pull out your brush, B. And after you've pulled out your brush, let's go up here and put hardness at 0. And let's make our brush size pretty big. Control brush sizes. As you see, my commands are down here, but you can control brush sizes by hitting right and left bracket. So I'm going to get a fairly big brush. And let's go with opacity, which is up here, about 10%. Now we're going to use a black brush, and we're going to paint onto our white layer. So it'll cover up any of the current layer wherever we brush and show what's under it. So I'm just going to do this very slightly, this layer, because I think the sky's a little bit too bright right now, but I don't want it to get too dark because then it'll look unnatural. Okay, I'm good with that. That's the only thing that we want to do with that layer, at least the only thing that I want to do. I think the rest is too dark. So now we're going to hit Command E. That's going to take the top layer and merge it onto the bottom layer. And now you see that we have a conglomerate of both layers. Now the next step is the same as the last. We're going to make a new layer mask. So layer, layer mask, reveal all. And now we're going to hide this layer mask. I have Command H set as my hide. You can also hit this eyeball. What do we want to bring in from this layer? I think we want to bring in a little bit more of the sky because it looks natural. And we can try some water. I don't think this water exposure is quite bright enough, but we'll give it a try. 40% black brush and start to brush in our water a little bit. I can hide this layer. And I'm going to go with 100 over here. Start to brush all this water in. And that takes the kind of bad looking HDR look away from the water. And we can come through and back. We can brush back our other stuff in a minute. good to have some extra detail in the lower layer. So always adjust these with some extra detail, and then you can come back and brush it in at just half opacity and take care of it. So here's the layer after topaz adjust was applied. And there's our old layer. So let's play the same game again, make a new layer mask. And let's hide it and see what we get. I like all these rocks in this down in here, but I don't like it at 100%. Let's use a big brush. Let's use it at 50%. Make sure your brush is black. Just brush in small parts of this thing. And I'm going to go with like 20%. Go some of these other parts. Remember, you can always hide it and see what's under there. See, this is bringing some nice contrast back into our foreground. It's almost making the vegetation look more lush and more natural as well. A lot of times I won't use this on water, but I think on the up top here, this water looks kind of cool. Brings the detail up. Really draws the eye up to that waterfall as well. This waterfall, not so much. I do kind of like this right here where it has some, almost looks like it's flowing. Do like that part, but maybe not that strong. So I'm going to brush a little bit of that back out. Hide it again, see what we get. Back to our black brush, I'm going to brush a little bit more of this in for that white, crisp white. Maybe a little bit more in here. I think I'm done. I'll go 30% here. I think we're, I think for some reason we lost some detail in here, maybe due to the mist. And I want this green to be nice and lush as well. Alright, we're starting to look pretty good there. Get all that detail in there. I think it looks pretty nice. So let's merge it down. Now we have this last layer. The last layer I'd like to use just for the water, but just barely any. So I'm going to go with like a brush of opacity of 5 or 6 and lighten some small areas of the water. When you're doing this, you want to make sure to watch your luminosity on your histogram and make sure you're not blowing anything out. So now I'm making my water nice and soft, and it looks like it's really flowing. So we're still good on our luminosity up there. Let's go in a few of these spots and get that in there. So slowly brush that water in. And then if you want to see what you've done, you can always hit shift and click on your layer and it'll hide it. So I think that's done a nice job to add some white to our, or some light, I should say, to our water. There we go. Looks good to me. So merge that down. Next thing you're going to do is hit save, and we're going to save this to our photos. And this is a Photoshop copy. I'm just going to name it Iceland Falls. So as you can see, we have from the histogram, we have a very nicely exposed picture. You have a little spike right here where it's light. That's the water and the sky. And then the rest of this nicely exposed photo is the rest of the picture. I am going to do a few adjustments here. So if you go down here to this little box and click it, it's going to make a new layer. And we're going to call this cleanup. I'm just going to use this to clean up some of these little marks up here. So I'm going to grab my stamp tool. You can also just hit S. For this, you want your opacity at 100. You want to make sure you have align sample clicked and all layers. Now what we can do is go up here and hit Option or Alt. So you want to hit Option or Alt in an area that you want to copy over this bad or dirty area. So I'm going to click it right here. Then we can just bring that over there and it'll copy that. So here, just do the same thing. See how it gets rid of all that stuff? And you can also do this right on the layer. I like to do it on sometimes crashes photos. I'm not sure why, but always good to save before you go to Nick. It's a program that I definitely love and I use on each picture. So I'm going to go to Nick, Color FX Pro. So once Color FX Pro is open, I like to go to the right one. You can see how much sharper that is. And I am going to sharpen the whole thing. I might go in here with a mask and maybe 40%. Since water's really not that sharp. Oh, make sure you have a black brush. You want to make sure your water flows and it's not sharp. And then, if you really want to get picky like me, I would come in here and have some of this be really sharp. Such as this. And then maybe some of it flowing. Some of it sharp again. Have that sharp. Maybe these rocks would be sharp. Then you could have parts of the water that are just flowing off over those rocks. And obviously up here, you want that transition to be nice, so. It's starting to look good. I really nitpick at details like this. You don't really have to, but it will make your pictures look better. So you can see already that's starting to look pretty nice. It always looks good to have transitions between soft and, I guess, sharp areas. So those look pretty sharp now. Make this look like a little horsetail coming off the edge there. And we're going to sharpen this up right here. So that's looking pretty good. I'm happy with that up there. Come down here and make sure this is everything we want it to be. That looks good. Make that flow. Make that really sharp in here. I want these rocks to be sharp. Those rocks to be sharp. And I think we're done. Actually, I might get this guy. There we go. That looks good. And we'll sharpen this up. And I'm happy with that, so I'm gonna go ahead and merge it down and save it. And that is the end of my HDR tutorial. I have a ton of free learning gear if you go to www.davemorrowphotography.com/learn photography. And you can find this under the tutorial as well. I'll